About a year ago, we had a wonderful woman who's part of our community, and she came to Nikki Lynch, our director, and said she wanted to donate a generous amount of money in order to benefit the community. But her particular passion was the children in the community. And so Nikki talked with her and, you know, had a few ideas, and she talked to me, and she knew that one of my passions was a garden, and so it was something that Nikki threw against me, and I ran with it. I thought that a garden for the children in our community would be one of the most important things that we could have. I thought the garden would make a huge difference in our community. It allows kids and teens and parents and adults to come out into a beautiful environment, enjoy the sunshine, the flowers, and learn about nature. In addition to that, I've always wanted to do nature-oriented programs, and this is the perfect vehicle for that. A lot of thought went into creating the garden. Instead of just focusing on what type of programs we could do, we wanted to think about how we could make this a really creative space and a place to really observe nature. So we added butterfly houses, bird houses, plants designed to attract a multitude of butterflies as well as birds, and in hope that the children will come to the garden and really learn to not only appreciate nature, but see, you know, what type of butterflies exist in this area. What are the birds going to be doing in July compared to September? I think we're a very fast-paced society, and nature observation sometimes gets lost along the way, and we want to make a difference with it. Another thing that I'm super excited about is the beautiful pergola. The kids can come in, they can play chess, they can play checkers, but we're also going to be using the pergola for programs. One of the programs that I'll be doing in the summer is a meet and greet for preschools and toddlers, and we're going to be doing a little picnic under the pergola. The pergola is surrounded by grapevines, which will eventually grow up around it, which will add some much needed shade in the garden. So parents and children and teens always have a spot to sit in that's really comfortable for them. So one of my favorite things about the garden is the area that's devoted for the kids to simply dig in. We didn't want this space to be like a classroom where they're just learning about gardening ideas. We wanted them to have a spot that they could implement them and be proud when they saw whatever it is that they planted come up. When I watch them dig in the dirt, it makes me so happy because they get so excited. Their eyes get huge. It's like nothing else that you could see in this garden. And then you know that they're going to come back in a couple of months and they're going to see what they planted and have pride in that. A lot of them do not necessarily have a space to garden, so this becomes their home garden. I love our labyrinth and our art rocks. We have large art rocks next to our labyrinth and chalk so that kids can draw on them. We don't feel that the garden has to be a perfect place. We want it to be a place that engages the children. And so it's okay if we have scribble on those rocks. If they enjoy it, that's the important thing. Going forward with the garden, we actually do not have a 5-year master plan. And the reason for that is this: we want to talk to the kids, talk to the children, see what it is they want. I have garden programs that I'll be doing relating to art and spring planting and heirloom gardens and nutrition, but ultimately this is the community's garden, and I want to hear what it is that they want us to do. And that's particularly important to me. I think the only way for this to really stay successful is to be fluid and to be receptive to their needs.